So the topic of today is news in the field of small robotics. And how do we define small robotics at KUKA? Well, actually, we have been very busy during the last few years in developing our product range. And what we're going to talk about today is really a big step in that field. So, as I mentioned before then, what do we at KUKA mean with our small robotics? Well, it is the Agilis series, which we've had in the market for quite a few years now, which is the six-axis robots with payload and reach from 4 to 10 kilos and up to 1100 millimeters in reach. They've been around for quite a few years now and are already in generation 2. We have the Delta robot, which was introduced in the market in the beginning of 21, and which is also what we call a hygienic machine, HM. That's what HM stands for. And that is because it is a stainless steel robot, especially designed for the food industry. And at the same time, we also have the Scara robots, which also were introduced at the beginning of 21. And we have two of them, both 6 kilo robots, but with different reaches, 500 and 700 millimeters. Now, all the small robots are also defined as they are controlled by our new KRC5 controller, the KRC5 Micro, which you see in the lower right corner, which is an integrated controller, not much larger than a shoebox, which makes it really slim and nice to mount and place anywhere. It has all ports and even IOs integrated from the start. So that is what we define with our small robotics. So, what is new and what am I going to talk about today then? Well, there are no news around the Agilis robots, but there are news around the Delta robots, the Scara robots, and the controllers. So let's start with the Delta robot then, which is today the HM machine, the stainless steel version, which is all stainless steel, which also makes it and has the FDA approval with hygienic oil inside. And it has a very high protection class, namely IP69K at the manipulator, which means that it can be cleaned with detergents or steam or high pressure water. And it also has a very high clean room specification, namely clean room class 5. Which makes it really suitable to use in the medical and in the food industry where you have direct contact with raw food. This robot has, during the years, been updated. So we now call it the Delta D1200-2. It is still the same robot, but we have managed to improve the performance of it by making it a little bit faster. The standard cycle has gone from 0.5 seconds to 0.46 seconds. But it is also faster in its positioning and repeatability. So the performance of that has gone up quite a lot, actually. You see the figures for that in the table right here. But that's not the only news we have on the Delta robotics. The bigger news is that we also introduce a completely new Delta robot. And we call that one the D3000. 3-1200 without the HM, because this is not a hygienic machine. It is a robot without the stainless steel housing. The arms are from carbon fiber instead of steel, which actually makes it faster. This robot actually has the same hygienic oil approved oils inside of it. That means that it is allowed for food handling, even this one, downstream, but not direct contact with raw food. It has the same payload and the same diameter of the working space as its sibling, the stainless steel robot. But it is also quite much faster. Thanks to its weight, it is quite much faster. I said before that the standard cycle of the stainless steel robot was 0.46 seconds in the version 2. Now this new robot do the same standard cycle in 0.32 seconds, which makes it the absolute fastest robot in our product portfolio and one of the absolute fastest robots available in the market at all. And we've actually managed to increase the working space with it a little bit as well. So the lifting height of an object is a little bit higher, 50 millimeters higher than in the hygienic machine version. And of course, this robot is also controlled by the KRC5 Micro, and it comes with a smart pad, as all our robots do. And you can then choose some software options which are suitable in the typical applications that these Delta robots typically do, namely vision contact to find an object, conveyor track if we need to track a conveyor and pick or place on that conveyor without stopping, and our software pick control, which actually can do the same thing as conveyor tech, but resource split the picking between several robots. If we have a very high material flow that one robot cannot cope with, we can use the software pick control, which distributes the load between several robots. So if we then move into the SCARA robots, which we have up till now two available products, namely these robots, these are now complemented by a complete new series of SCARA robots, which are 12 kilos instead of the 6 kilos, which the older ones were. And they have three different reaches from 650, 750, and 850 millimeters. But there is a fourth version inside of there, as you see, which has a reach of 750 millimeters. But as all of them have a minimum Z stroke, which is the vertical stroke of 400 millimeters, we also have one version which has a stroke of 600 millimeters. So this robot can really pick or place objects which are placed deep in some kind of bin. And actually these 600 millimeters in stroke is the absolute longest stroke available on the market for a SCARA robot. And actually the news consists not only of these robots, but also of three clean room versions. It is the same type of robot, 12 kilos with three different lengths or reaches, a little bit less in the set, but they are also clean room class robots, suitable in the electronics industry or in the medical industry. And if we look a little bit into the differences of these, the standard version has a full ESD that is electronically isolated so it won't disturb other equipment, and it's an IP20 ceiling class of this robot. But the clean room version is IP54 and also holds the clean room class of ISO 5, which makes it a very high clean room class. So there are in total 7 of these new SCARA robots from KUKA. And they are quite fast. The standard cycles are between 04 and 042. That means that there is actually 1/100th of a second difference between the 650, the 750, and the 850 reaches. So the longest reach is 2/100ths slower in the standard cycle than the 650, which makes them really, really fast. And just like its older siblings in the KUKA world, you have the connection on top of arm 2 with both electric and air connections. But as you see to the right, there is a huge difference between the older SCARA robots and this new one. You see at the top of the old SCARA robot, you have the hose and the cabling in a separate hose on top of the robot, which you can see up here in the right corner. And in these new robots, there is no such hose. The cabling is internal in the robot, which makes it much more useful to get into tighter spaces, since we don't have to consider where the hose, cable hose comes. So this is, of course, a great advantage for you. And just as the Delta robot, this is also comes with the KRC5 microcontroller and the SmartPad 2, and can, of course, be used with the same type of application software as the Delta robots I mentioned before. And if you are using pick control, which combines several robots into one picking application, you can actually combine robot types. So one of the robots could be a Delta and the other one a SCARA, which is quite possible in this solution. Now, that means that our range of small robotics has grown quite a lot, if we remember what I showed in one of our first pictures. And that also gives you a very wide variety of robots to find the right robot for every thinkable application, to optimize it for that application. And actually, if you look at speed and reach and payload and functionality, that actually makes us the market leader in terms of what we can offer you right now in the field of small robotics. Now, before we leave or stop for today, I have a few more news to talk about, which concerns the KRC5 microcontroller as well. For those of you who have already used one of these small robotics and seen the microcontroller, you see it here on the left-hand side, and knows that it is an IP20 unit, which needs to be built in a cabinet. And we have now made available a micro cabinet on the market, so you can actually buy one cabinet for built-in for them from us, KUKA. And finally, we have been waiting for this actually for some time. We now also have the possibility to connect external drives to the small robots with the KRC5 micro drive module, which is a control box which looks exactly the same as the microcontroller itself, but hosts up to 4 external axes. So the drive box actually contains 2 external drives, but the main controller can handle up to 4 external drives, then you would need 2 boxes. And it connects through a KUKA controller bus to the main controller. and they are 12 amps maximum on the external motors. And they support the KL100 linear track for the small robots or just standard motors as well. So I know that a lot of customers have been waiting for this functionality within KUKA. And the other news is the micro cabinet, a standard cabinet from us, which can host up to 2 units. For example, the microcontroller itself and 1 unit of micro drives. And has a number of options in terms of lock options and the front panel interface. But it also expands the I/O bus directly outside, so you don't have to connect it inside of the robot or cabinet, for example. So this is also a feature which has been long awaited of many of our customers. But this cabinet is an option, standard. The robots are delivered without this option, just the microcontroller itself. So this is an accessory to the robots if you need it.
Industrial intelligence.